Hey guys, welcome back to Warren Mechanics. In today's video guys, we're going to go ahead and show you how to drain the front differential oil on Porsche Cayenne, Volkswagen Touareg or Audi Q7. As you know, they share the same platform. Differentials are pretty much interchangeable depending on the... Everything is the same except sometimes the ratio could be a little bit different, but the casing is the same, draining and refilling is the same procedure. We'll show you on a Porsche Cayenne, but the Touareg and Q7 should be the same way. As you know, they're prone to making that noise, like something like a wheel bearing going out, especially on the front right side or left. And most people replace bearings and it's not. It ends up being the differential, that's a weak spot on those. And we'll have a video how to rebuild one, but we'll replace it with a thicker oil today and see if that will fix any of our noise, because it was extremely bad. So stay with us, we'll do that, we'll show you how to get to it, and we'll show you the end result, if it has any improvement or not. Now we'll have more than 200 videos on this car, so please guys, subscribe to the channel for more videos, and if you need help with anything, drop a comment below, we'll try our best to make a video for your problem. So you can see with the vehicle in the air now, it's way easier. Now we need a Phillips screwdriver, so we need to remove that cover here, the engine cover underneath. Now with 10mm socket, we need to remove all these bolts. One of our bolts actually requires a Torx 30, and most of those you can remove them with 10 or Torx 30, I'll show you in a second. Okay, you can see inside they have a Torx 30. Okay, perfect. Now we have all the bolts on the front side that mounts towards the bumper. Okay. Now let's see if that plastic will come down and what else is holding there. There is one more bolt under that cover there. Okay, one on this side, one on the other side, under that little bitty plastic piece. Okay, perfect. Now, we should be able to pull the engine cover down. Okay, like that. So once you lay under the car here, okay, and you remove all the covers and everything, okay, this is your front differential there. Okay, let me get it and get the light here. Okay, this is the drain plug on the bottom. That's super easy to remove, right? But the fuel plug is actually, okay, right here. Okay, and our Allen wrench does not fit. It's an 8mm Allen wrench, but we need to cut ours to make it work. So we'll cut it probably about 1cm in our case and see if it fits. We will try to get that plug loose before we drain it. That way, if we drain it and we cannot refill it later, we didn't screw up. So let's attempt to do that now. Okay, so this is our Allen wrench and we're going to cut it now. You have to be extremely careful. It's a very dangerous job how to do that. So that's what we will be doing today. Okay, so I'm going to hold it here really good. Okay, let's see if that is going to work. If not, we'll cut it more. So we're going to get a 10mm socket with extension. Now we can even actually use an 8mm that will fit the wrench really good. But in our case, we'll get the 10. Okay, perfect. And let's go ahead and see now if it's going to fit and if we can take it off. Okay, that's a filler plug that we'll be undoing first, remember. Usually once those things, okay, start going, they go by hand super easy. Okay, it is the just the first little bit that it gets really, really tight. So we'll do that until we pull the plug out. You can see it's not too bad, but that's how we do it. And we're going to drain the oil and see if we have any metal shavings or anything like that. Okay, this is the bottom one. We're going to try in just a second what is going to come out of it. You can even smell that differential oil, it smells so different. So we'll get a jar to collect all the oil and see what it comes out of it. That way we know we want to clean everything to see for metal shavings and hopefully guys, hopefully that will work. Now, that procedure should work on Audi Q7 and Volkswagen Touareg as well, because they share the same platform, the same differential. You can check out in the video that we will remove the differential, that it has even a stamp on the front side that says Volkswagen. Okay, let's get it loose now. Perfect. Okay, and the first sign is the oil has that metallic shiny look, so that definitely doesn't look normal to us. We will let it drain and come back in a second. Okay, it drained all the way now. We're going to put it together, a little bit of metal pieces on the bottom, we notice, we wipe them down. Okay, well, we have to make sure that we don't forget to get the bottom one tight. Remember, we have the top one loose now, so we can refill it. That's what we did first. We're just going to do it a little bit with the extension, but not too much. Okay, that's it, perfect. So, let's go ahead and inspect the oil now. Okay, so this is the oil. Don't look at the pickles and the tomatoes, look at the oil. Okay, that's metal shavings in the oil. You can see how it settled down. So definitely, definitely something going on. It differential, most likely a bearing. Okay, right there, guys. That's bad news. So we'll be rebuilding the differential soon. Okay, check out now when we stir it up. You can see the metal shavings in the oil. Okay, you cannot feel them. It's a really fine material, but check out the metallic color on it. It's kind of like metallic paint. Yep, right there. Okay guys, so we have the holes here. I think it's a 3/8 hose. It goes all the way in the differential. Okay, and being so high, we can actually extract the fluid through the bottle that way. Okay, that's what we will be doing. We just put it upside down and gently squirt, but we did that until we add as much as we need or until it starts coming out of the plug. So that will be doing now. So let's see what else we need to do. Okay, it started leaking out of the filling hole. So this means that it's enough oil. It's a little bit less than liter that our took. I always recommend to check your manual and stuff. Okay, so we're going to pull the hose out and we're going to install the drain plug. Get it tight now. Okay, we're getting the plug tight now. Do not forget actually to use the Allen wrench towards the end to get it tight all the way. And it took a while with the bottle and the hose. Probably took us about 20 to 30 minutes for everything. But it's not too bad. You can see this is the bottle, practically almost empty.
Towards the end, we use the compressor just to clean the hose one time. You can actually put a little bit of oil, then use the compressor to push that oil through the hose, but you don't have to do that stuff. So let's get it tied now with the Allen wrench. Okay. And that will be all, guys, from that point on. So thank you for watching. Please hit that subscribe button for more videos, and see you guys next time.